Welcome to the subcommittee of the Health and Human Services Committee. We have one bill on our agenda today, House Bill 520. It's for a hearing only. We're not voting on this bill today. Let me just remind you, we're going to limit individuals to 2 minutes just because we've got a long list of people signed up and we may not get to everybody today. And we'll get started.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Okay, Virginia Hammond.
Madam Chair, of course I leave this to your discretion. There might be a couple of points that require some response, but I'll leave that to your discretion either today or later.
Hi, thank you for letting me speak.
Can you hold the mic a little closer so we can hear you? Thank you.
Sure, can you hear me now?
Yeah.
I'm here to say a few things on a more personal note. Part of this bill is to allow information to be passed from one entity to another to facilitate better care for patients. I'm here to speak about my own personal experience with antidepressants. I've been a long time sufferer of depression, and I changed jobs back in 2019. Had to change health insurance companies because I changed jobs, and when that happened, my new insurance company would not allow me to continue taking the antidepressant that I had been successfully taking for several years. They wanted me to stop taking it and go to a cheaper alternative. That sounds very reasonable on the surface, but the reality is it takes 4 to 6 weeks for an antidepressant to become effective. It also takes several months to come off of an antidepressant. So when you ask a patient that's dealing with depression to change their prescription, you're talking about several months worth of issues, problems, health problems. I missed work, and it was life affecting. So I don't think a lot of people know that that's the case, but I think it needs to be looked at. It's difficult. You can't just stop one and start another. It's difficult.
Thank you very much. Barbara Bush.
Thanks.